morning, everyone. Good morning. Welcome to our new episode this week of the Winning Mondays, where we here talk a lot about the stories of how we can help all of us win as we move forward in this journey. Just a great reminder to everyone, on October, we are now in the third week of October, entering the third week of October, and the year of 2021 is ending very fast. How many of you feel that 2021 is ending very fast? If you feel that it's very fast, please press 1. If you feel that it's very slow, please press 3. How many of you feel that it's very fast? Very fast, press 1. Very slow, press 3. All right. How many of you want to go faster? Press 5. Okay, nobody want to go faster. Oh, someone want to go faster. Awesome. Right. And a lot of times we are in this season where as the market opens up, as we are traveling was allowed, you know, over the weekend, yesterday, actually, I went to Bukit Tinggi. I crossed to the state of Pahang for the first time in my life in this past whole year, right? Never really crossed state. This is the first time I crossed state. It was so nice to travel the highway. So it was also very nice to see all the businesses starting to come back up alive, right? Now, the question I have for everyone is this. When the market is opening up, which is it is opening up, how well prepared are we? From a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being totally not prepared, 10 being I am prepared, please state what state of preparation are you in right now? 1 being not prepared, 10 being very well prepared, what number is your preparation? Put it in the chat box. 1 to 10, from a scale of 1 to 10, where are you? Anyone? Come on, just put it in the chat box. Someone is 5, someone is 7, what else? 6, great, what else? 3, awesome, 8. Good, thank you for being very honest and transparent. Preparation is very important, right? But how do we prepare? What do we prepare? What do we do? I thought this morning to kick the conversation off, before I interview our guests, I will spend the next 15, 20 minutes talking about a few things that will help us to prepare our business as we go along this market opening, right? So I want to just quickly play a short 7 minutes video. Let's watch a movie. I've got a lot of good reviews when I play snippets of movie during training sessions, right? So there were a lot of requests from the ground saying that, John, can you play more movie snippets to help us understand certain concepts a little bit better? So I'm going to play this short clip of this movie, and then we have a short discussion about this, right? So Marcus, please fire away the movie, please. Thank you. Hey, how many of you remember this short movie? This movie called The Karate Kid, starring Jackie Chan and Jaden Smith. How many of you watched that movie before? If you have, say yes, if you watched that movie before. How many of you have not watched that movie before? Good movie to watch. What were some of the things that you have learned from that snippet just now about preparation? Anyone? What are some of the ahas you got from watching that movie just now? What are the things that the master was trying to prepare us to? Foundation. What else? What else? Attitude. What else? Repeat. Repetition. Consistency. Doing simple things consistently becomes stronger. Practice. Absolutely, yes. What else? Mastery, right? Self-mastery. Respect. Right. Awesome. What else? What are some of the things that you are learning from that particular short movie? Treat people right. Practice. Make perfect. Patience. So the goal of firm, being strong, because if you keep doing the same thing over and over again, you build something called muscle, right? And it becomes very natural. What is consciously competent become unconsciously competent, right? Repetitive, right? Focus, right? Never give up in times of trials. Awesome. Find the right person to help you. Muscle memory, absolutely right. Muscle memory. So one of the key things that I want to just share this morning with everyone here today, if in your business today, if you are thinking about what can you do to prepare as the market opens or as we prepare for the year 2022, there are a few key things that we need to think about. And if you watch that short clip just now, one of the key things that you should think back is there are a lot of things that you have to do consistently, repetitiously, and it has to be very boring. And I argue if you're not doing things consistently in a repetitive mode, and if it doesn't feel boring, likely you may not be on the pathway to succeed. Because there is this conception or this perception that success is actually very exciting. Success is actually very adventurous, right? It's something very interesting, it's very different. But I back to defer. I think success itself is boring. It's all about us doing the same thing over and over again so well that we became masters of what we do every single day. And sometimes there's this illusion that there is an easy way in order for us to succeed. And I don't think there's something called easiness, right? There's no something. There's this actor that you and I probably know called Denzel Washington. And he says very clearly that ease, right, is the enemy of progress. When someone is looking for an easy way, he is not looking for progress. Like and that's the enemy of progress. And for me today, to share this with you today, I want to give you three key handles as you prepare your business. Number one, what's your goal? That the guy, the young boy just now, his goal is he doesn't want to be bullied anymore. He doesn't want to be looked down upon anymore. He doesn't want people to hit him and bully that he cannot fight back. But what's your goal? What's your GPS? How many of you are clear of your goal? Because the goal is the one that determines how you show up every day in your work, how you show up every day in your life, the way the existence of yourself, it is up to depending on what your goal is. There's no such thing as a good goal, bad goal, there's just goal, right? I think there is goal that is realistic and goal that is unrealistic. And an unrealistic goal is something I always talk about this very frequently, is when you set a business goal that cannot pay your bills, that is an unrealistic goal. Right? So are you having a GPS? Are you clear? Number two, how once you have a goal, what's your preparation on a daily basis? What do you do every day that is critical that will help you be very clear that you have a pathway to succeed? The first, I see there's three T's that you need to prepare every single day. Three T's, right? The first T is your time. I'm going to spend a bit more time here today talking about time. I have this famous quote I used to quote for many, many years. I say, if I'm coaching you today in your business, show me your calendar and I will tell you how likely successful you'll become. You see, in order for you to have an output, it is then be determined by your input. The income that you want to earn, it is determined by what you do in your time. What you do in your time has to be very clear. I'm going to show you a quick example. This is my calendar I'm going to show you right now. Can everyone see my screen? Can you all see my calendar right now? So I'm going to let you come into my life for just a little bit, right? This is my calendar. Now, you will see there are white boxes, there are colored boxes. White boxes are time block boxes. Colored boxes are something new that I just added on as I go along the way. So if you look at my calendar, this is my time. I am if my Mondays are always full, Tuesdays are public holiday, Wednesday, Thursday, every day, it's filled with things that I'm supposed to do. That's my next week's calendar. That's my week after's calendar. This is my November's calendar. And I can tell you all the way up to December, my calendar is designed, is fixed. There are a lot of things going on in my time. My question to all of you here today, how does your calendar look like? Because the way you put time into practice and into play will determine the outcome. Time is very important. How you use your time will determine the outcome that you have in your business goal. Second thing is, what are the tools that you prepare every single day? Are you using scripts? Are you using clear tools that will help you tell you who you should be following up on a consistent basis? Are you using a tool like opportunities that will help you be clear who you should be talking to and how often should you be talking to? What are the scripts that you use every day? Now, I look back at my calendar and I look at my coaching tools that I have. I have a few coaching tools. And I was just doing a quick calculation last night as I was preparing today's session. I calculated I have spent at least 360 coaching hours in the past 2 years to focus on using one tool called the need analysis. Because of that tool that I'm using consistently, now it's becoming very natural. I can ask you 3, 5, 10 questions that will help you see through where your business is. So those are the tools that I use. The third thing is, what's your temperature? Meaning, where are you right now? What is your measurement? Do you know how many appointments you have? Do you know how many listings that you've taken? If you have a GPS today, you have to ask yourself on a daily basis, what's that temperature? Are you measuring what you are doing? So the challenge is this: there is a huge difference between movement and progress. Do not be deceived that doing a lot of things that doesn't bring progress are things that doesn't mean anything. What are you doing that is measured, that is showing you progress? An example of progress is how many listings you've got today, how many appointments you have set this week. And trust me, this business is about listings and appointments and relationship. Those are the fundamental things that you and I must be doing on a consistent daily basis to see through us succeed in our business. If you don't do those work, nothing will happen. This business is not complicated. Just like that Kung Fu stand just now was not complicated. You take out a jacket, you put your jacket, you put it down. It's that simple. In our business, it's about contact, relationships, and listings. If you understand all these three things, you will likely have a better business as we go along the way. Number three is to repeat and improve everything all over again. These are the three things that you do to help you prepare yourself to run a business. I don't know how many of you today are clear of what you need to do when you wake up in the morning. Now, I argue with people, I say, if you don't know what you need to do every day you wake up in the morning, that is not a good life to live. If you are still waking up every morning wondering what I must do today, something is very wrong with your business. Very wrong. If you're not clear what you should execute on a daily basis to hit your goal and measure your goal, something is very wrong in your business. You need to revisit. You need to talk to someone. You need to reach out to your market center leadership and say, I am lost. I need someone to help me go through my GPS. We cannot help you to do your work, but we can help you to set your GPS so that you know what you need to do on a daily basis. Right. I hope these three key things, what's your goal, your GPS, number two, your preparation, which is the three T's, the time, the tools, and the temperature that you should check in your business. And number three is to repeat all those things and improve. If you don't do all these things, simple things to prepare your business, our business is not complicated. We spend too much time focusing on how to convince people to buy something from us. That's not what we need to do. We need to focus on how many people we should talk that will buy something from us. That's a different perspective. There is this illusion that we have to learn how to not to fail. We have to learn how to do certain things that is guaranteed success. The only guarantee I have for you that you and I will fail as we go along the day, as we go along the activities that we do. But it is through the failures and the lesson we learn from our failures will get us to where we want to go. So to have this mindset of, teach me one thing that if I do, everything will be okay, that is it's a crazy mindset. It's an illusion. It doesn't exist. It's like, I want to lose weight if I just take one pill. Today, if I take one pill, I will lose weight. That is an illusion. It doesn't exist. That's not how you lose weight, right? So I thought today's session was to start the conversation with this perspective. And before I introduce, I hope it has been very valuable for you to understand those three key things to set yourself thinking. Now, to just give us some perspective and to see some sort of application in what I just said, I wanted to invite our guest from Market Center 3, Karen Ong. Karen, are you there? Can you hear me?
Hi, morning.
Good morning, Karen. Good morning. Morning. Yeah, so Karen is a new REN. I think with us for about a year or less than a year. So Karen, would you introduce yourself, that you're from Market Center 3, but would you introduce a bit about yourself? What were you doing before real estate and what are you doing right now?
All right. Hi, good morning, everyone. My name is Karen. I'm from Market Center 3. And before I joined Redfield, I was with Malaysia Airlines, air hostess for about 18 years. Then I quit the job and I go back to tourism industry. I'm a tour guide actually. So Malaysia tour guide. And about 2 years after that, MCO happened. So when MCO this one fall, I have no job to do. I stay at home. So while waiting at home, I was thinking as well, I pick up this property. A lot of tour guide doing property as well. So so I also like, why not I just try myself? I'm actually zero in property line. I don't know anything about SPA, you know, getting loan. I have zero knowledge. So I joined at Brickfield, and thank you Brickfield for training me from a zero knowledge of property until today. So at least I know what it's about, all this, how to do advertisement, you know, and how to set my goal, all this from this Keller Williams, this, the whole thing. So from there, I become today. So still very fresh and very new.
Right. Yeah. Thank you for sharing that. Can you share with us, how long ago was that? Was this November you joined us? November last year or December last year, is that right? Less than 12 months?
Actually, I joined, I think, around June. When June? I come in, yeah, straight away, you know, command things, you know, I get very panicked and then I don't know anything. It's so confusing. So right. Actually, it's still new, yeah, for this.
Right. So about 1 year already in the business,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, 1 year.
Right? All right. Can you share with us, for the year of 2021, how has your business been so far in terms of your production? How many transactions have you done so far?
Okay, since I joined 2020, nothing. And start from January until March or so, nothing happened. But I came on doing some advertisement. I managed to get a property. I start first, right? And then H prop. So from March onwards, got one or two case. I managed to close. So up to today, I think from now until March until September, lucky that I managed to close about I think about 8 closing.
8 closing, awesome.
Yes, 2 is co-broke, yeah.
Right, and in the month of September, tell us what happened. You have 4 transactions worth 4 million. Tell us what happened.
September, my lucky month. Yeah, it was my birthday month. I think it's my lucky month. So suddenly everything come back to me. You know? Because when I do the advertisement, all this listing, I got it in January, February, March, then closing only in September. So I also get a shock when I have the closing on this lab. But there's 2 that I really, really touch is because one of these is like a buyer that following me for so long. I've been showing him so many houses and he really stick to me. Every time he want to see house, he will call me. Hey, Karen, I want to see the CMD. Can you bring me there? So I will call the agent at Cobrook. So after so many viewing, I almost give up on him, but we see because too many house, you know, tired. It's like, is he playing fun with me or making use of me? So it's like, why should I, you know, waste my time? This uncle don't want to buy or not, right? But end up in September, he really close one deal with him. He really buy a 70 in Kingsley Hill. And this one very touched is because he there's another agent will come in and then, you know, give him a more discount, 20,000, but he choose me to be the agent. He willing to give up the, some agent come in, you know, tell the buyer, hey, if you close this deal, I give it 20,000 discount, I cut my commission, I give you, but he doesn't take that, he stick to me. He's scared that I scold him. So right. I really touch on this relationship with him, until today, we are just a friend.
Right.
Yeah.
So how we get this right? So from January onwards, you'll be building a listing bank. You've been doing the things that you need to do. You've been preparing yourself and you started some closing in March, April, but September was a big bang for you because you have 4 sales done. Can you tell us what's the highest volume, what value property that you transacted? Like one property that's the among your 8 months of your journey right now here this year, what is the most expensive property you sold so far?
So far is the Kingsley Hill, the 2.1 million, but this one is a co-broke with another agent.
Right. So 2.1 million is something you achieve in an 8-month season as a rookie agent, right?
Yes, yes.
Right, right. Can you share with us how many listings do you have right now?
A listing?
Yes.
Actually, I didn't manage to, some already sold, but I didn't cut it off.
Right.
About 70 in each pro, I was 70 over listing.
Right.
And renting about 20.
Right. 70 over listing for sale, 20 about for rental. There's about 90 over listings that you have. What is it that you do on a daily basis that helps you get your listings?
Actually, when I'm new, I totally have no referral, nobody. So what I do is I do SMS, at first SMS blasting, But after that, kena block already. So fed up, so we go another one. WhatsApp also I try, but block already. So I don't want to try that. So actually I do SMS blasting every day. When I start from a condominium. So I get the listing from Market Center and then I really send one by one. Sometimes one night I send 100 over out, but only one reply or sometimes no reply. Right. So from there, but I keep on doing every day, actually.
Right.
I want to, like, you know, I give myself 1 year. So if I can make it, I make it. If I don't make it, at least I earn a knowledge. So right. I'm not losing anything. So I just try on that. So right. I have my consistency and every day I send SMS out.
Right. And, and in your journey of doing this consistently every single day, right, were there times where you felt that, like, giving up?
Yeah. Because sometimes, you know, when I send SMS, they reply and then they even call back and then they scold me. They say, you know, you're abusing this one, they shouldn't, this privacy thing, why. So I just apologize. And then sometimes no reply, you know, 100 over, 150 you send out, not even one come back to you. So, but I keep on doing it. So I just try myself. But managed to get 2 good listings after I so many plus out. And 2 is good enough already for, you know, for the good house. Yeah.
Right.
Good listing.
What is your main motivation that keeps you doing this simple thing on a daily basis? What motivates you to every day do the same thing over and over again?
Yeah, because I want to get my goal. I set my goal because I'm a new rookie, right? So I want to achieve my 80K in this year. At first, I set my goal is 120K. Then by the month of June, I say I better go down a bit. So I reschedule my GPS to 80K. So it's maybe easier for me to achieve. So I just go for that goal and then do it every day.
And you almost achieve it right now. You're almost there. Right?
Already there.
So you've already achieved your goal because you're very clear you must achieve this. You are very clear. What is the motivation behind you wanting to achieve this goal? Do you mind sharing that?
Motivation, actually, John, I have I'm a retired, you know, almost retired, so I really got no other thing to do.
Right.
So I don't want to stay at home, be a housewife. So I like to learn things a lot. So to motivate me, I can say that it's my family lah. So, you know, I can do it. I enjoy doing property, actually showing people house. So motivation, you can say, I say I want to earn extra money.
Right.
Yeah, since MCO got nothing else to do.
Right.
I cannot go back to my previous line also. So as well just do this one.
Right. And the people that your friends or colleagues in the circle of tourism and the circle of airline and all that, right? Everyone is getting hit. Everyone is going through a very tough time. Do you agree?
Yes.
Very difficult. There's no jobs. There's no opportunity. And yet you decided to do this because you feel that you need to make something happen because you want to be able to give something back to your family as well. Even in this time, you refuse to stay at home. By the way, you don't look like you are in retirement because you look like 25 years old. Right?
Probably
it's the camera. Maybe it's the camera. Okay, so you're not retired, right? Let's not go into retirement. Right. But what are some of the things that you do, or what are some of the things that has helped you to stay focused in what you are doing right now? Can you share with us what are some of the things that help you to stay focused to do these things consistently? What are some of the tools that you have? Is it the GPS planning? Is it the training? What are some of the things that help you to be focused in what, to be able for you to do what you are doing right now?
Yeah, actually, it is a mindset that the training by refill. I attend classes every day, you know, every Monday, you know, so 8-9 classes or so I attend. I never miss any of the class because I want to learn as much as I can. So once I pick up, then I will get more knowledge. So when I start to have my buyer or seller, then at least I know what to do. So that period, I focus on learning more. At the beginning, I didn't go for closing or want to have fast because I see my friend joining other company. They can tell me, hey, 1 month already, I sold one house. How come you join so long, no house one? I say, I'm still learning process. So I take my time to learn as much as I can. So once I have opportunity, at least I'm ready.
Right.
Yeah. Right.
So you are spending a lot of time preparing. You believe that preparation is very important. All the basic foundation, getting the listings are very important. What helped you to connect with your clients better? Because you mentioned just now that that client didn't want to betray you, didn't want to even, didn't take that 20,000 discount and still come back to you, right? So what do you think that you credit to help you to build that relationship successfully with your clients?
Actually, I think it's because when you do something, you do it truly, be yourself, you know, you're not trying to cheat people, you know, you want to be nice to people. At the same time, it's your character, your attitude itself, that people will feel it, whether you are genuine or not. So I always be myself and then treat people. I stand on their shoe, how they think. So that's how they feel it without telling. So now we have become friends. So not all buyer like that. So this is only two of them are like that. The rest buyer just come and go. So, but it's not so close like this two.
Right. So, but it's a lot of thinking about how to add value to the client, right? How to help them make sure that this is the best opportunity. But thinking on their shoes, standing in their shoes and thinking about them. So it's relationship before transaction, right? You are thinking about the relationship first before the transaction. And that's very powerful. That's helped you to build. Can you share with us right now in your pipeline of buyers that you're working in? Are you having a lot of people that you're working with potentially to close transaction right now?
Right now, I have few listing that very motivated seller. They want to sell, but the price still not very good. So I focus on that. So it means that I want to focus on this. Not all the listing are ready. Focus on the motivated seller. That is the best for me, because a buyer still going to look for a good house with the right price. So motivation of buyer is very, seller is very important.
Right.
Good listing with motivated seller is number one.
Right. Yeah. Why do you think that's important? Why do you decide to say that that's your objective, to help the motivated sellers to sell off their property better? Why do you think that's important right now?
Yeah, because I find out that in 1 year, I mean, in this industry, I realized that actually buyer will still buy a house, not because of Karen Ong. Yeah, they want to have the house that they want. So, but the one that I have, the friend one, is different. But out of 10, only one, they're looking at my relationship, you know. They need time to build a relationship. So this uncle, elderly, they need a service.
Right.
But the young one, I realized that they just see, you know, one house, they do ngam, they see the other agent, many, many house. So this is a buyer where they have to cash.
Right.
I realized, right? So yeah, I have buyer that, you know, viewing so many houses, so many agents, they don't stick to me, but only one or two will stick to me, and then whenever they want a new house, so they want different pace, they want is more to relationship already.
Right.
So I think motivated seller, a good listing is number one.
Right. So focus on working on the relationship with the owners of listings will drive you more buyers, because the buyers are attracted to listings that is priced to sell.
Yes.
Right, yeah. Awesome. There's a question by Susan here. Karen, can you share how you can get 70 over listings in such a short time? What do you do? What pill do you eat? You got to take any medicine?
because I blast SMS, so whether the listing good or not, I still put in the H. Because the H property, like the more you put, your advertisement will be more to see in the webs. So that's why I push some listing, I put a double. You know, to attract like a condo, if I have one condominium, there will be a few for sale.
Right.
So there are already a few there. So condominium is more to have more listing.
Right.
So
it's basically every day messaging the listings and your database and asking for listings from the database that you have, right? It's just blasting the SMS, blasting the WhatsApp. That's what you do every day, right?
Yeah. Sometimes I lazy, I skip, but most of the time when I slow down, I realize that I need more listing coming in. So I have to continue doing it. Action, you know, because we have all the knowledge, but we don't action, that's, you didn't get anything. There's no result.
Right.
So,
right. How many hours you spend a day getting listings right now?
Now SMS, I think, I time block myself. If I have viewing afternoon, I will be my viewing session. For morning, when I wake up, I check my emails and I will do my 1 hour, just SMS. Sometimes 50, you know, you just SMS out. Yeah.
Yeah. So about 1 hour to lead generate for listings. Then you call the owners. When they respond to you, you communicate and you call and you get listings, right? Roughly per week, how many listings do you get a week, roughly? Just a ballpark figure right now.
A week, very hard to say, because lately I focus on the hot listing that want to sell. You know, I'm always look for a motivated seller. Which right. one is the hot one? Or either other agent is coming in, I have to act very fast. When I have opportunity, I have to act very fast. If not, it will go away. So if you ask me, I supposed to do lead gen every day, but sometimes I also skip. But when I sit down, I realize that I have to continue get more listing.
Right. So, how many hot listings you get in a month, like right now, or in a week? How many hot listings do you get?
Yeah, hot listing in 1 month.
Yeah.
There's no I can't trace. Yeah, I can't trace
right.
that.
Right.
Yeah.
Do you think you have more than 5 to 10 listings hot?
No. Less than that.
3 to 4.
Because I really, you know, I blast out. That's why I say sometimes we get 100 SMS out, but not even one come back. So there's no figure I can catch it. But once I got it, I will grab it. That's why.
Right.
I'm still working on my old listing. And I realized the old listing, you need time. Because when a hot one, they won't sell it in 1 month. And then it's very hot. I have a listing that within 1 month, I sold 2 houses. 1 month, 2 viewing, 3 viewing, done already. The one is hot listing. But if the listing very cold, you have to wait half year to close one. So I cannot just focus on that listing. So I normally, I look for the listing motivated, the seller, easy to talk to, then I go for that.
Right. So there's a question here. What's the definition of hot listing? I'm assuming hot listing is the listing that is priced to sell right now. That when you put it in the market, everybody want to take a look.
Yeah. I have 2 houses like that in USJ 11. This one also from SMS. I SMS out. That happened that timing also important. Happened that they wanted to sell. Other agent also SMS, but happened that they pick up my SMS and they reply me. So I'm the only agent selling for them. So within 2 viewing, 3 viewing, close already. So I can say that also lucky, unlucky. And also lucky plus your hard work, you know, your action. Yeah, then your opportunity is there.
Right.
You cannot miss out anyone. Yeah.
Right. Awesome. Guys, how many of you are learning something from Karen today? One of the things that I'm learning from her is that she makes things very simple. She don't complicate things. Let's just do the simple things every day. Let's just make things work every day by just getting listings that can sell. Yeah, just focusing on listing or owners that are motivated to sell. Then I will work closely with them. I will put them in the market and I'll get the viewings done. Right. So very simple, guys. This business is not complicated. It is quite simple. It's just that you need to do a lot of work. You need to be very, very, very productive and very, very consistent in your what you do, right? Anyone got any questions, please put in the chat box right now. I'm sure Karen is learning, is here to help and give some thoughts to you. You're learning something right now. Not too analytical, just doing what is important. Absolutely, like Chris Wong. It's very simple. It's not complicated. Make it simple, right? Karen, what are some of the things that you want to focus on towards the end of the year, for you personally in your business, what is that one thing that you want to focus on right now?
I continue, because I achieved my goal already, I want to be a bit relaxing, but I also want to continue get more listing. Right. I focus on getting it, because when I closed the last September, I didn't do a lot of lead gen, because I focus on this, running here and there to get the closing done. So now I have to get back my daily lead generation. That one is number one now.
Right. So just that 1-2 hours a day lead generation for listings. And then put your listing out in the marketing portals or whatever you're doing to just let people know. That's simple. And then afternoon is your appointment time. Is that right?
That's
what you do every day. It's just consistently doing this every day. And that's how last month you got 4 sales. Worth 4 million. Right. So guys, if you want to make that 4 million in that 1 month, this is just what Karen did. Just make sure you get all the listings done every day, right? Go for viewing in the afternoons, because if your listing is priced correctly, you will get that leads. You will get that appointments, right? What are you preparing yourself for 2022? Do you mind sharing? What are some of the things that you are doing to prepare yourself for the year 2022? Are you thinking about 2022? What is something that you want to achieve in 2022? Because you have already hit your goal this week, this year already, right? You hit your goal this year. What is your plan for 2022 look like?
I would say that I want to set my new goal in 2022 and continue doing action.
right?
Yeah, action for doing what I'm doing for this year, lah.
Right.
Continually generation and then improve, get more knowledge, you know, so right. Improve myself, like, and repeat what I'm doing. So I think opportunity always there for me, lah.
Right. And how do you work on setting a goal? What would you do to set a goal? What do you think that you need to do in order for you to set a goal for next year?
We have the training, right? The GPS.
Right.
Yeah, go for the GPS.
Right.
Yeah.
Your GPS. Mm-hmm. There's a question on the chat box here. Why didn't you join your friends to go other company, but why you choose to join Refill?
Be honest to you, because when I don't know anything about property agent, what they do, what is company also, I don't know what company they have. So right. It happened that there's one of my friends that also tour guide, also airline, and then he a Refill agent in MC1. So I asked him, then he said, are you sure you want to join? I said, yes. So I want to join. So he said, Refill give a lot of training. So if like me, zero knowledge in the property, so just go for this. He give you a lot of training. And we even have a productivity coach. Right. My productivity coach is Ray. So he really helped me a lot. When I'm not a good negotiator. When I negotiate, then I will call Ray. Please help me, Ray. So I always look for Ray. So thank you so much, Ray, for spending his time. You know, productivity coach is so important for new rookies like me, lah. So I really call him, always to ask for something, you know, anything. Right. My agreement also don't know how to fill out. So I will call Ray, help me with this. So right. I really appreciate all the training they've given.
Right. Yeah. So the support, the training and the productivity.
Yes, yes.
Ray Chua from
Ray Chua, yes.
Right. That's helped you to set that goal. And then now you're looking at your GPS. So that's very important. So guys, I hope you are getting some nuggets of wisdom here from Karen. What are some of the things that you're learning from her right now? Please put in the chat box just to make sure that we are helping you see some value. What are some of the things that you are learning from this session today? Please put in the chat box right now. Right. Please put in the chat box. Right. Be learning based, consistency and accountability. What else? What are you learning from today's session? Come on, put it in the chat box. Virtual support, please check workplace as well. Is there any comments on the chat box as well? Use your GPS wisely. Focus on motivated seller that is priced right. This is the market right now for that, right? Anything else that is not priced correctly may not be the best option for you. Consistency will reward you in the future. Just focus on what you can do now. Results will come. Absolutely, it'll fund. That's what you need to think about all the time. It's you need to think about how to make those consistent stuff valuable right now, just like that movie you just watched this morning. Okay, while waiting for the last thoughts, hang on there, Karen, for a few minutes. I'm going to go for some announcement. Then after that, I'll come back to you for some last thoughts. Can I have the announcement, please, Marcus? Thank you. Right. So again, if you want to be like Karen, put your listing on the HBROC newsletter and make it a spotlight. We have 24 or 46 last week. So please put that spotlight so that when it's out there, you get more presence and get more attention from the clients and the public, right? Next slide, please. Again, touching points. Look at the price to write and attract buyers kind of touch points that we are focusing on. Just like what Karen is saying, all the touch points and the scripts that we have is to help you have that conversation with your client about the listing that they have. It's about pricing it correctly so that you will attract more appointments and more viewings, and it will give you that more opportunity to help them sell off their property right now. So please use the touch points that we have. You'll be seeing more of this as we go along the way that is relevant to the market, right? Your feedback on this is also important. If you think there's better ideas, please let us know so that we can improve and change some of these touch points for your benefit. Okay, next slide. Right, Karen, last advice. What are some of your advice for an agent who is listening right now, who is thinking of what I should do? There are some agents that might be lost right now, or some agents that is not clear what they need to do on a daily basis. What's your advice for them?
I would say that because like if I can do it, I'm sure that everybody can do it. Just don't stop doing what you're supposed to do, lah. Set you have already had a goal. So now we just focus on action. You must have action, then you will see the result. The result could be in you earn a lot of commission, right? Money, or if you don't have that, but knowledge also is priceless. It's very important. So we're not losing anything if we know. But main thing is lead gen means that our action is very important. Hard work will pay off one. If you don't work hard, then you get nothing sitting down. Even though MCO, I still viewing, you know, my this one. Yeah, because I cannot travel. in the state, so I only can focus on Subang Jaya close by my house. So I still wooing with the permission of the owner and also two visitors. So that's why I never stop doing anything. That's why I get my result today, lah.
Right. So don't stop.
Just don't do stop. It. Give yourself, you know, 1 year or 2 years. 1 year, lah, you want to set your target. If I can achieve, I do this line. So like me, maybe I wouldn't go back to tourism industry, right? I will continue doing this one, like if I can find. This is an interesting job, actually. Think positive and like what you're doing. Right. That is very important. Then you will have the energy to work hard. Yeah.
Right. Thank you so much, Karen, for being an encouragement to us. Thank you for showing up and using the tools that we have. And thank you for coming to all our trainings and showing us that all this matters and it helps you to build your business. For those who are listening today, please put on the chat box your gratitude and your gratefulness to Karen for sharing. If you can, express your gratitude in the chat box. I think it will help Karen to continue on her day positively. Please express your gratitude to Karen on the chat box so that, that she knows that whatever she has said and done has become a blessing to all of us here today. So Karen, with that, thank you so much for doing this. Thank you for taking time off your business to be with us. Looking forward to see more results from you, more achievements that I think it's a matter of time. I think you are positioned to be one of the top producing agents in your market center if you just keep doing what you are doing. And please don't go back to tourism. Stay in real estate. Stay in real estate and become a better real estate agent. Okay. Thank you so much, Karen. You all have a good one. Take care, everyone. See you on next session. Thank you so much.
Thank you.